Did she get donkey today? Please tell me.
I have become donkey of the day.
At the Breakfast Club, bitches.
You're a donkey.
Yes, donkey of the day for Tuesday, February 5th goes to Liam Neeson. Now, yesterday in an interview that Liam Neeson did with The Independent, he confessed that he once roamed the streets looking for a random black man to murder.
Mm-mm.
I repeat, in an interview Liam Neeson did with The Independent, he confessed that he once roamed the streets looking for a random black man to murder. No need to hear me repeat it again. You can listen to Liam Neeson say it yourself. Let's go to The Independent for the report, please.
She told me she had been raped, but she handled the situation of the rape. I asked, did she know who it was? No. What color were they? She said it was a black person. I went up and down areas with a cosh, hoping I'd be approached by somebody. I'm ashamed to say that. And I did it for maybe a week, hoping some black bastard would come out of a pub and have a go at me about something, you know, so that I could kill him.
He said black bastard with a
that
hard
is
B,
crazy.
A hard L, a hard A, a hard C, a hard K, and a hard bastard. Now, context matters. Liam didn't say he just wanted to kill a black man for the sport of killing a black man. He wasn't doing any big game black bastard hunting. Liam Neeson had a friend who was raped by a black man. Therefore, that made him want to go kill a black man. Here's the thing, Liam Neeson, and the reason you are getting donkey today. Your friend got raped by a black man. Therefore, the only black bastard you should want to kill is the black bastard who raped your friend. Okay, I know that a lot of white people think all black people look alike, and some of you think we are all one big monolithic group, but we are not. And killing a random innocent black man because your friend got raped by a black man is not going to solve anything. So let's not use your friend's rape as an excuse for you wanting to kill random black men, because I feel like you would have that desire regardless of if your friend got killed or not. Now, I'm gonna play white devil's advocate for a second. I respect his honesty because I don't think we can heal things we don't reveal. I also think that when you're honest about how you truly feel about something that you have done, you have to be prepared for the backlash. I think that the same way I, as a man, have to unlearn a lot of the BS I have learned in my life, Liam is dealing with the fact that he clearly was a racist and that his racism led him to want to commit a random act of violence against a black man under the guise of seeking revenge for a friend who was raped, which makes zero sense because, once again, the only person you should have wanted to kill is the person who actually raped your friend. Please let Kathy Griffin handle my light work.
Please give this giant jar of mayo the biggest hee-haw.
Now, did he mention in this interview about how he got past that and why he doesn't feel like that and how wrong it was?
I didn't hear all that. I didn't listen to the whole interview either.
Because I want to make sure he doesn't feel like this still.
I heard him say in a 24 interview with The Guardian that we all racially profile. It's a horrible thing to admit to, but we all do it. I know I do, end quote. And I think he did talk about how he learned from it.
Yeah, he learned from that, yeah.
But I did learn a lesson from it when I eventually thought, what the f*** are you doing, you know? And I come from a society, I grew up in Northern Ireland and the Troubles, and I knew a couple of guys that died on hunger strike, and I understand that need for revenge, but it just leads to more revenge and more killing and more killing, and you know, all the stuff that's happening in the world at the minute, the violence is proof of that, you know.
He said it was how he grew up in Northern Ireland during a period of intense political unrest. He was fueled by the misguided belief that indiscriminate violence was a reasonable response.
Imagine if he would have came across a black person at that time.
Yeah, but he said he was hoping that a black person, you know,
would start some issue with him. Yeah, so he
I mean, listen, man, I think we all have prejudgments.
But let's open up the phone lines. Let's talk about it.
I do stereotype people, but that's because I have years and years of psychological programming that have conditioned me to do this. Okay, but
I wonder if it was a white person, if he would have been looking for a white person to kill.
It's a good question, Angelique.
Well, let's open up the phone lines. 800-585-1051. Was he wrong for feeling that way?
I respect Liam for saying this only because it allows us to have a conversation amongst each other and this as a society. And this is how you get to a better understanding of people. This is how you clear up misconceptions and downright lies.
But see, this is a tough one because if it happened to somebody in his own race, would he feel that way? No, probably not.
Yeah, would he have said white bastard?
Nah.
What is Liam? I don't know.
You know, I don't think he would have felt that way.
He's Irish
bastard.
Yeah, he's Irish.
I'm Irish too, by the way.
We know Leonard McCurvey.
Yes, thank you. Charlamagne the God here, and today's Donkey of the Day is brought to you by the Law Office of Michael S. Lamonsoff. Don't be a donkey and call my friend Michael if you've been hurt in a construction accident. 212-962-1020. That's 212-962-1020. Don't be a donkey.